Just mind the upholstery while you're looking for nothing.
Yeah, sure thing.
Well, I guess I don't have to worry about breaking this.
Now this happened.
Fucking hell. Damn thing must have fell off the table.
Uh-huh. The lamp just fell off the table.
Or the boy was faffing about, playing sods and swordfish. Who knows with the lad?
Sods and swordfish? Still plugged in. Busted latch.
Your lock's busted, too. This place is falling apart.
Eh?
The lock. It looks like somebody kicked in the door.
Oh, for Christ's sakes, a fucking lock's been busted for weeks, mate. Right, it's just like everything else in this bloody building.
Is he hiding that guy in this in his apartment? And why? Because he's afraid. I guess the guy threatened him. Hurt him and his family. I'm not gonna talk to him just yet. I'm busy exploring, looking for clues. Oh, we got a blood stain. That's right. We must have a pretty good
just some wood rot.
Sense of smell.
Not mold or anything.
You bleeding?
Why is that?
It's blood. Still fresh.
Oh, well, I cut me hand. Ran around like a tit trying to pick out a rap.
Let me see your hand.
Must have got some on the furnishments.
Sounds painful.
Oi, don't you go mother-ending now. The wound didn't sit very long, you know. Perks of being a fable, I suppose. And a frog.
Why do frogs heal faster than others? Scratch on the window? Oh no. Uh-huh, I see. Examine the marks.
What is it now? If it's blood, you know what happened.
No, there's marks here on the windowsill. And what's that about?
No real reason. Just last night, when I'd come out, I was in a downright dizzy, mate, as you would be. And I plumb forgot the keys to this place. And I had to climb in through the bloody window.
Really?
Scared Junior off to death.
I don't know if those are marks with a... for a toad's
you
fingers.
You heard the new Shakin' Stevens album yet?
You talk too much.
If you're gonna say something, out with it.
Why didn't Junior let you in?
Junior was home. Why didn't he let you in?
It was the middle of a sodding night, Bigby. I'm supposed to wake him because his jammy daddy didn't remember to check his pockets.
Toad talked his way out of that one. Did he now? Oh, what's this? A fireplace poker with blood on it. Now, isn't that interesting?
And what happened here?
The poker? What of it?
There's more blood on the tip. Did this happen before or after you came in the window?
After. I was poking the coals and it slipped a bit. Sliced up in my foot like a seashell. Looked like a shit ugly thing. Okay, Sheriff, now what?
I guess that healed too. I thought you cut your hand.
Wait, you dropped it on your foot? You told me before that you cut your hand.
Yeah, no, I did cut my hand. I cut my hand first, and that made me drop the damn thing on my foot. A ruinous flip of events, really.
You talk his way out of this one, too?
Oh, my God, will you not make a big faff out of this? There's nothing to solve here, Sheriff. I'm telling you everything that happened. Why don't you believe me? I mean, things happen, you know.
I think you're hiding something.
No crime in a little accident.
I think maybe you're hiding something.
Hiding something?
Maybe. But, to tell you the truth, I don't know yet. A but I know you're lying about something.
But I'm not-
And you're just gonna make it worse for yourself the longer you keep up the act.
I'm not bullshitting you. Honest.
Are you bullfrogging me, then? I couldn't resist, guys. Anything else to look at? Oh, we got something here. Dust ring. Oh, and then up here. Oh, Snow's standing on the other side of the door? I gotta imagine she's crouched behind the post. Let's look at the dust ring.
That more blood?
No. Just a clean space in the dust. Did you move something?
Oh, maybe one of Junior's toys or something? I mean, who knows?
Unplugged. Something was plugged in there, too. Was that formerly why would someone move the lamp? The broken lamp was here.
That broken lamp used to be here, right? Just tell me what happened.
Nothing happened, mate. Nothing! And why did the lamp have to be there? Of all the blooming pointless inquiries. It's my own place. Don't you think I'll know what happens in it?
The power outlet.
Because it wasn't on that table, Toad. There isn't any room in the electric outlets.
Oh, that's not what was plugged in.
It was plugged in over here, and now it's there.
I did some refiguring.
It was
who fucking cares?
And
it
not
was
plug it
thrown.
In. Come on, Toad.
I just hadn't gotten around to it yet. You see how many damn plugs there are? Bigby, come on. I'm begging for mercy over here, old boy. I was looking forward to a nice afternoon. Just me and me son, and you've taken up enough of a day with all this... They're sniffing around at me private belongings.
It's been like 10 minutes.
Sorry I called, really I am. But will you please just bugger off?
No.
Not yet.
Not yet? You say to my face that you think I'm hiding something from you.
That's right.
I've had to go out of the room for a fair bit of time now. Nothing's here.
I'm not done.
So when? When are you gonna leave? I mean, I feel like I'm on trial here. In my own bloody home. It's not seemly.
When I say so.
When I say so, Toad.
Well, I've told you the truth, mate. Jesus Christ, what more do you want?
The actual truth. I'm not gonna threaten him.
I cut me end. I broke the lamp.
You lied, Toad.
I forgot my keys, so I climbed the sill. There's no more story to tell, mate.
Toad, these... stories have made no sense. You didn't cut yourself on the poker. You didn't forget your keys. You want to tell me what's going on?
He's afraid. He's hiding.
He doesn't think much of me.
This
I
guy.
Don't think.
Oh, I wouldn't necessarily say that. Progress?
Oh. He
Mr.
got...
Toad, you're bleeding.
He got hit in the head.
Take off the hat.
That guy attacked you. He threatened you, didn't he?
It was that butcher, a Tweedle, Dumbledee. You gotta strip them down to their johnnies before you can tell which is which. Hmm. They come bulging in, screaming about something a woodsman had. Or thought he had, I don't know. He tore up the place, beat me up when I said I didn't have it. I tried to go out the window. But he pulled me back in. It's been a hard morning, I could tell you that.
Was he looking for it? Oh, nope, I didn't say
Do
anything.
Do you know what he was looking for?
Thanks,
I have
Snow
no
White.
Idea. I would have told you. I wanted to, really, I did.
But
he said if word of this ever got back to him, if he ever thought you knew, or Miss White, he'd come back and kill my boy.
I figured it was something like that.
You even tried to give the bastard a coat. You wouldn't take it.
Whose coat?
The girl.
Dad borrows things from people who live here. Sometimes.
Borrows?
I don't steal nothing. Turn around here would astonish you, mate. I merely repossess what's been left behind.
Well, we'll be taking the coat now. If she has next of kin, family, anyone.
All right. Fetch him the fur. Fine bit of dress it is.
Fur? A fur coat? Oh my god, you stuffed it back there? What? Oh, that's her...
No, I wouldn't wear it outside.
That's her donkey skin.
Wait.
She keeps that thing? Or kept that thing? There's a mysterious object. Looks like a letter.
It's an envelope.
Fucking hell, of course there is. For my luck, it's a map to some bloody doubloons.
It's addressed to Prince Lawrence. Do you want to try and give it to him, or...?
Don't make it a dilemma.
It is a dilemma. I can't resist my curiosity, though.
Just open it.
I have to open it. Yeah.
Bigby.
Sorry, Lawrence. I can open it.
I'm sorry, Faith.
That's it?
What could she have been sorry for?
I don't know.
Another mystery.
But maybe Lawrence does.
Well, it's been quite a surprising day for all of us, hasn't it? I'd see you out, but I'm afraid of dripping any more blood in the place.
It was very nice talking to you, TJ.
Thanks.
TJ.
See ya.
I just want to look at this really quick. Nope, no new, Book of Fables entries. You know, though, I'm just kind of curious. Yeah, I got 6 more to uncover before we're done. I wonder if there's a possibility of missing any of them. I do not want to miss any of them.
Does it always go that smoothly?
Not often.
So, the prince's now?
Lawrence's, yeah. It's our best lead.
Our only lead, really.
That's I was about to say, our only lead.
Put it that way.
Lawrence's apartment, South Bronx. Early morning. How are we falling,
I don't
want
to stay here any longer than we have to, so let's just pick an approach and stick to it, okay?
Okay.
Just humor me.
Let's focus on what we saw
in the magic mirror showed me this apartment. I think I saw a knife inside, covered in what looked like blood.
And
I wasn't expecting that.
His chest.
Well, like I said, let's not overcomplicate things. You can question him while I look around for it.
And if he objects?
We're here on official Fabletown business, and we can be persuasive if necessary. Or you can.
She's like the Lois Lane of this story. And, we're not entirely Superman. Let's look at this window. So he's in the South Bronx. From royalty to the South Bronx. Congealed soup? No standing anytime except trucks. Loading and unloading. As a fable, we have an inability to cross the street. Well, just seems that way. Okay, we have to press up to go sideways. That's disconcerting. Oh. Look at the door. Oh, it's not closed.
Don't just peep into someone's house. Check if he's home.
I am checking to see he's home by peeping into the house.
Can you hear me?
I think he's dead.
Are you okay?
The TV's on the same image. Okay, he's definitely dead. That's what she's smelling. Oh, now he's not sitting in the chair. So when did he fall out of the chair? Before or after he died? I can use Lawrence? I'm not into that, mister. I guess I should... Yeah, I should look at the body before. It wouldn't make sense. What am I using here?
Oh my god.
He's... Help? He's...
Hey, hey!
Not
stay
dead?
With me, Lawrence. Gonna no. be alright.
No. Let me go.
How do you kill these people?
What is it that you're telling us?
Etz?
Bigby, water. Kitchen.
Water. Alright. Let me just go over here for a second. I don't think there's anything over here. Right. I can't look at the weapon yet, though I'd like to. Let's go in the kitchen. There's probably other stuff to look at in there, maybe. Let's look at this note first. Pay the rent next week. Pizza in the fridge. Please don't look for me. Goodbye.
Did you find it yet?
What's her note? What's her name again? Faith. Faith, right? That's Faith. F for Faith. There's that column of water again. I know, it's stylized. Oh, I thought I could look at that up there. Got water.
If you have something to ask him, you should do it now.
Probably only get one chance. Who did this to you?
Who did this to you?
Faith.
Faith did it to you? Was he actually answering my question? Or was she just worried about her? If she killed him, then who killed her?
Do you still have that letter?
Yes.
Doesn't say much. It says, I'm sorry.
Only two words, but he died without seeing them. I'm sorry. We need to figure out what happened here. Find whoever did this.
Yes, we do. Okay, new Fables entry. I'm gonna check that first. Lawrence, I presume? Prince Lawrence, Faith's husband. After escaping the homelands, Prince Lawrence and his wife, Faith, immediately fell victim to the harsh realities of the mundane world. They moved to New York, hoping to find aid in a community of fellow Fables. Without enough money to live in Fabletown, they had to settle on an apartment on the outskirts of the neighborhood. Unfortunately, that meant they were out of sight and out of mind when it came to government assistance. Was the government assisting the Fables? Or did the Fables have their own government? Their prospects dwindling, Faith left Lawrence to try to make it on her own. Now without his wife for support, Lawrence struggled to motivate himself and quickly sank into depression. So she left him to try to make it on her own. I don't think she killed him, even though I asked, "Who did this to you?" And he said, "Faith," twice. I don't think he was actually answering our question. I think his last thoughts were just on her, and that's why he said her name. Guess I could be wrong. Let's look at a picture of the two of them here. In happier times.
When do you think that was taken?
Before all this.
Before the Exodus? There's a bullet hole.
Bullet passed through the chair. The angle works if you shot himself.
Use a bullet hole. we have a bullet. Or not. Okay. Maybe not. And now we just look at it silently. Okay. Blood. Yeah, that'd be blood, alright.
Strange. Hard edge to this pool, like something was here and got moved.
Hmm. Yeah, really. Moved into there, yes? Touch the blood.
Still a little sticky.
Not fully congealed. Let's look at this knife.
It's sharp. There's blood on the blade.
What kind of symbol is on there?
Is that the same knife you saw in the mirror?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know why it's over here.
I just don't understand. Why would someone want to kill him?
That's what we have to find out. Can't look at it again. There's some symbol on it. I wish I could actually see that. So I could see he was hurt when he was sitting in the chair. Was he attacked further? Well, not attacked, but he shot himself. Well, no. If he shot himself, then what's the knife about? Yeah, very interesting. Let's just examine him one more time, see if we come anything up with anything different. We're looking at the chair, though. Okay, now we're looking at the medicine, which I wanted to look at.
What are they?
Empty?
Prescription sleeping pills.
Did he try to kill himself in so many different ways? Oh, there's a gun here. Did I not notice the gun? I myself did not notice the gun. Shell casing. Let me look at that gun too. The bullet we have fits in there. I'm not gonna check that. Okay. Look at the gun.
What is it?
This gun wasn't fired recently. Maybe a week ago. Or more.
Oh. So, yeah, because we don't smell gunpowder. It's obvious, like, as a wolf-type creature, he has a good sense of smell. So, did he try to shoot himself a week ago? Failed? And then took sleeping pills and then stabbed himself? Or did someone attack him? Yeah. I don't know if that symbol is going to come up as anything. Huh. Nice shoes.
They'll be on the grip and the trigger.
Turn off the fan?
That doesn't really help.
Oh, sorry, I don't have an option to turn it back on, Snow White. I don't know what to tell you. There's nothing else to look at. At least not in this area. Alright, before I start messing with the doors, let's look at the bookcase. Couldn't look at that
before. Secondhand paperbacks. Old encyclopedias. Dusty. No one's read these in a while.
Hmm. Check in here one more time. Get the note again. Goodbye, Faith. I wonder when that was written. How long ago? Could be from very long ago when he kept it there. And The only thing left is this. Something stuffed in there to where the doors won't close. Oh no, that's a bed. I thought it was a closet doors or something. Oh, there's another note. From Lawrence. There's a note from Lawrence. My dearest Faith. I never meant to hurt you and I can't endure knowing that I have. This was for the best. I'll see you again. Love, your devoted Lawrence.
It stuck to the bed a little.
My blood?
My dearest Faith, I never meant to hurt you, and I cannot endure knowing that I have. This was for the best. I'll see you again. Love, your devoted Lawrence.
How did he hurt her?
Hopefully they're together now.
About all we can hope for at this point.
Okay, now what? She's looking at the box. I thought I could look at that on top. Are we done then? We just leave? Oh, we can leave. Where even is the door, actually? Something else we have to look at. I want to pick up the knife and take it with us. It's evidence. Oh, look at the phone there. I can't look at the phone though. So when I look at him, she comes over. The bullet hole again? I don't know. We're done in here. Let's see anything else to look at. I can't even walk this way. Can't even. Oh wait, that's new. This is, I haven't gone this far before. If I go this way, yeah, we end up, okay, let's open the closet. These are the closet doors. Oh! Holy crap.
Stay here.
I was not expecting that. Oh my god. All right, she's not staying there.
Hey, stop. Leave me alone.
Never. Just throwing stuff at me. Come on, yeah. I heard the door close, so it's. You stay on this trail. And I grab this foot. Oh! Oh, crap. Oh, my. Ouch. How do you make that jump better than him? That way. Oh!
Hey!
Gotcha.
Ease up, Bigby. We're on the same side here.
You son of a bitch. Make me run after you.
Who are you?
Who are you?
What?
Who are you?
Listen, man. I'm a private investigator.
Tweedledee?
A man's dead.
I know how it looks, but I had nothing to do with that.
You're covered
Bullshit.
In blood.
You're covered in blood.
Look, I was just asking him about the girl. That's all. When I mentioned her being dead, he freaked out. I figured someone had told him. How was I supposed to know? Shit. Fucker shot himself right in front of me. I couldn't stop him, man.
That gun hadn't been used in over a week. Or at least a week.
You're looking for the woodsman, right? I know where he is. My guy says he's holed up at the trip trap. We can go over there right now, the both of us. My employer's looking to ask him a few questions, too.
Who are you, really?
Who are you, exactly?
I'm Dee, and I'm a private investigator. There's a business card in my shirt pocket. You can see for yourself.
Tweedledee. Maloney's Bakery and
Sandwich
Shop.
Really? Huh. Must have run out.
I called your
Who
bluff.
Hired you?
I can't tell you that. It's confidential. Sorry. Sure you understand.
Nope. Can't say that I do.
I was about to say that
Come
now.
On. You're coming with me.
This could have been easy.
Oh, don't worry. It still is. Come on.
It dumb. Still is.
Dumb? Yeah, it is.
Oh, watch out.
Look, it'd be much easier
is
for you
no.
to...
Brothers,
I'm D.
Coming.
He's dumb.
Ow.